name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
La paz del Señor esté con todos ustedes.
Y con su espíritu.
What a beautiful moment of faith as we witness the dedication of our sisters, Carmelites of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, particularly those three sisters who are going to renew their vows in a very important anniversary. 25 years, 50 years, 60 years of dedication to the Lord and to the Church. May God grant us the grace to all of us to renew our own commitment with them, our own commitment with the Church, our own commitment to be truly disciples and missionaries of Jesus Christ. Let us now be mindful of our sins as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess
to the Lord God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. And therefore I ask Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
El Señor Todopoderoso tenga misericordia de nosotros, perdone nuestro pecado y nos lleve a la vida eterna.
Amén.
Oh,
Holy Father, who though urging all the faithful to perfect charity, never cease to prompt many to follow more closely in the footsteps of your Son, grant, we pray, that those you have chosen for this special calling may by their way of life show to the church and the world a clear sign of your kingdom. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my father's." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. He looked, and there at his head was a hearth cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him, and ordered, "Get up and eat, else the journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate, and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. There he came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake. But the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire. But the Lord was not in the fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. A voice said to him, "Elijah, why are you here?" He replied, "I have been most zealous for the Lord, the God of hosts, but the children of Israel have forsaken your covenant, torn down your altars, and put your prophets to the sword. I alone am left, and they seek to take my life." The Lord said to him, "Go, take the road back to the desert near Damascus." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The bridegroom is here. Let us go out to meet Christ the Lord.
The bride is here, let us go out to meet Christ the Lord.
Hear, O daughter, and see, turn your ear. Forget your people and your father's house. So shall the king desire your beauty, for he is your Lord, and you must worship him.
The bride is here, let us go out to meet Christ the Lord.
All glorious is the king's daughter as she enters. Her raiment is threaded with spun gold. In embroidered apparel, she is borne in to the king. Behind her, the virgins of her train are brought to you. They are borne in with gladness and joy. They enter the palace of the king. The place of your fathers, your sons shall have. You shall make them princes through all the land.
Have right.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you, who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now for a little while you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him, you rejoice with an indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Disciples, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine grower. He takes away every branch in me that does not bear fruit, and every one that does, he prunes, so that it bears more fruit. You are already pruned because of the word that I spoke to you. Remain in me as I remain in you. Just as a branch cannot bear fruit on its own unless it remains on the vine, so neither can you unless you remain in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever remains in me and I in him will bear much fruit, because without me you can do nothing. Whoever does not remain in me will be thrown out like a branch and wither. People will gather them and throw them into a fire, and they will be burned. If you remain in me, and my words remain in you, ask for whatever you want, and it will be done for you. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The priests
this case, Bishop, should not use the altar to preach. But because of the situation here, there are many people all the way to the entrance. I will deliver the homily from here. Voy a decir la homilía desde este lugar. Ordinariamente hay un lugar para la homilía, pero sabiendo que hay mucha gente, vamos a tratarlo mejor. También les voy a poner un reto a los amigos y bienhechores. Benefactors and friends, please get a PA system for the sisters. So if you don't hear well today and you're a struggle, what can I do? And even if the chapel is small, you know, this is good for the sisters to have that kind of equipment so that they can enjoy the whole celebration of the Mass easily. And for all of you, we'll do the best we can. Queridas hermanas, es un honor estar aquí con ustedes en este maravilloso jubileo de vida consagrada y que tres de ustedes han vivido con intensidad. 25 años, 50 años, 60 años. Esta vida a la que han sido llamadas es un hermoso don y es un ministerio. Es un servicio. Un don porque viene del Señor y no de nuestra propia creación. Y un ministerio porque no sabemos específicamente por qué el Señor nos ha invitado a ser parte de su iglesia por puro amor y para servirla de muchas formas, porque si su vocación especialmente es la oración, sirve de muchas formas, no nada más de una forma. Los sarmientos deben responder a la vid, especialmente en la primavera, ya que los sarmientos en esa estación dan mucho fruto. Cuando la savia de la vida fluye, trayendo crecimiento y vida nueva. Dear sisters, we appreciate your consecrated life. And we know that this is a gift from God, but also is a ministry. A ministry, the gift of God is easy to relate to. God gives your vocation. You answer. God gives you that vocation. But then God calls you to serve in the church, in the world, through prayer. And you don't know every time that you pray how your prayer will be effective. There are many ways it will touch people's lives. And the gospel tells us about the vine. And the vine flourishes in the springtime when the sap of life surges forth, bringing growth and new life. We must always return to the vine as the source of our nourishment and strength. No matter how many years we have been responding to the Lord's call in His light, you will be able to see how the Lord, because you are connected with them, is helping you to fulfill your vocation. Pope Francis said, at this year's celebration for consecrated life, let us look to our own lives dear consecrated sisters. Everything started in an encounter with our Lord. Our journey of consecration was born of an encounter and a call. We need to keep this in mind. And if we remember aright, we will realize that in that encounter, we were not alone with Jesus. There was also the people of God, the church, young and old, and old. So we cannot separate our call from God's people. It comes together. El don de la vida consagrada, dice el Papa, comienza en el encuentro con Jesús. Y no es un encuentro, son muchos encuentros con Jesús. Pero ese encuentro de Jesús no termina ahí. Ese encuentro con el Señor lleva a la persona consagrada a vivir en el encuentro con los demás, en el servicio a los demás. Encounter with the Lord, and not alone, but in the midst of the church. These are two very important points to keep in mind as we celebrate this vocation to the consecrated life. We encounter the Lord in so many ways, in our hearts, in our conscience, in the sacramental presence of the Lord in the Holy Eucharist, in the other sacraments, confession, baptism, confirmation, the anointing of the sick. We encounter Christ in the ordained ministers. Also, we encounter Christ and the holiness of God in our midst, in His Word, in the members of the community in whom we share life, in the poor who knock on our door, and in the many ways we are exposed to people, particularly you, sisters. The Jubilee we celebrate today is part of that response of a whole heart to the Lord and to the Church. An undivided heart. It's not I belong to God, just prayer. Prayer alone doesn't work. As just service to people doesn't work alone for a consecrated men and women, for us, people of God. It's prayer and people. People and prayer. Our response is for the whole church, and even more, for the salvation of the whole world. We must never forget this. We must recall that Saint Teresa of Lisieux, which is the patroness of the missions, worked so hard for the whole church. And you know it. Saint Teresa Benedicta of the Cross, another example, is the patron of Europe, of many people, a woman of prayer, no doubt. And her faith helped to the revival of those societies in Europe. Saint Teresa of Avila is one of the doctors of the church. Convents, they don't live for themselves and for the people who live in the convent. Convents are for the life of the world, the church. And you have been doing that for many years. So, my dear Jubilarians, rejoice and be glad, because you have been connected to the vine, and you have bear fruit in your own lives, your own sanctification, in the sanctification of your religious community, and in the sanctification of many people. We need sisters like you. You have chosen the prayers for vocations. People of God, I began placing a challenge to you about the PA system. But that is simple. You just give a little bit more money and you will have a better sound. But the true challenge to all of you lay people here is, if we are honoring these women and we value them, sisters, Carmelite sisters, and there are other sisters here present, we'd like to stand up, please. Sisters. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 sisters. And from this community, only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I will tell you this, people of God, as I have heard it myself, constantly working to promote vocations for priesthood and religious life. If you do not work for vocations out there, these will disappear sooner or later. That's the truth, or not?
Yes.
What do you say, sisters?
Yes, Father.
So let's work. Let's help the sisters. The PA system could be here or not. And we will yell. We'll scream. But we need more women joining religious life. It's urgent, urgent, urgent. Es una urgencia. Y ellas son las primeras con sus vidas que tienen que ayudar a que haya más vocaciones. Pero es el trabajo de todos nosotros que decimos, ¡ay, qué hermosa monja! Chula, chulísima, hermosa, hermosa. ¡Ándale, trae otra! Find another one. It's beautiful to say, oh, the sisters, oh, son lo máximo. Hay que ponernos las pilas, ¿eh? Hay que trabajar. We need to work with God's grace to bring candidates to religious life. Otherwise, these beautiful sisters, they are not for eternity here on earth. They are called to eternity. And they are going to leave to be united with God forever when God calls them. We need to help. So, may your call of prayer, sisters, particularly you, the Jubilarians, as the first reading invited us, it's true, we go to special places to pray. You have this special place to pray. And you will find the Lord in so many ways, and even in the breeze. Sometimes the Lord is very loud. Sometimes he's very soft. May you continue listening to his voice. And may his voice in you find an echo in the way you help us all to get closer to the Lord. Amidst our joy and amidst the turmoil of our lives, I leave you with these words of Saint Teresa of Avila that you know very well. Let nothing disturb you. Let nothing make you afraid. All things are passing. God alone never changes. Patience gains all things. If you have God, you will want for nothing. God alone suffices. May Our Lady of Guadalupe continue inspiring all of you. Some of you were born here in the United States. Some of you were not born here in the United States. And you have been faithful, been inspired by Our Lady of Guadalupe. And she continued helping you to be faithful till the end, until the Lord calls you. And meantime, we will find more sisters for your community. Please be seated.
You will be coming one by one. Brother priest, would you like to be here with me to witness the vows of the sisters? And I would like also the Mother Superior to be here with us. So that you will witness the vows and then you will renew your mind.
Hi, Sister Guadalupe of the Most Holy Trinity, Hilda Guadalupe Guadarrama Dominguez, in the presence of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, Saint Father Joseph, and of our holy patrons, vow to the Holy Triune God, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule of Carmel and the constitutions of our congregation, to the greater honor of the Divine Heart of Jesus.
Lord, look upon our sister, whom you have called in your providence to follow your Son in the Carmel of the Divine Heart of Jesus. Accept her joyous thanks for the years she was allowed to spend serving you as her neighbor. Mercifully grant that she may complete with loving perseverance this way of your love, which she once began with joyful expectations. Yes, this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I, Sister Anne Barbara of the Divine Heart of Jesus, in the presence of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, of Saint Father Joseph, and of our holy patron, bow to the Holy Triune God, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule of Karma and the constitutions of our congregation, to the greater honor of the Divine Heart of Jesus.
Lord, look upon our sister that you have called in your providence to follow your Son, the Carmel of the Divine Heart of Jesus. Accept her joyous thanks for the years she was allowed to spend serving you and her neighbor. Mercifully grant she may complete with loving perseverance this way of your love, which she once began with joyful expectations. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
In the presence of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, of Saint Father Joseph, and all our holy patrons, bow to the Holy Triune God, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule of Carmel and the constitutions of our congregation, to the great honor of the Divine Heart of Jesus.
Lord, look upon your sister whom you have called to your providence to follow your Son in the Carmel of the Divine Heart of Jesus. Accept her joyful thanks for the years she was allowed to spend in serving you and her neighbor. Mercifully grant that she may complete with loving perseverance this way of your love, which she once began with joyful expectations. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the presence of Our Lady of Mount Carmel, of Saint Father Joseph, and of our holy patrons, bow to the Holy Triune God, chastity, poverty, and obedience, according to the rule of Carmel and the constitutions of our congregation, to the great honor of the Divine Heart of Jesus.
Lord, hear the prayers of your church. Look with favor on your handmaids, whom you have called in your love. Grant them perseverance on the way of eternal salvation. May they seek only what is pleasing to you and fulfill it with watchful care. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let's congratulate our sisters for the Father, for it is He who gives the grace of our vocation.
For the Holy Church of God, that adorned by the virtues of her children, she may shine ever more brightly for Christ her bridegroom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all bishops and clergy, that they may shepherd the flock entrusted to them, especially the suffering, the persecuted, and those who have strayed, according to the heart of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For Sister Barbara, Sister Mary Alice, and Sister Guadalupe, as they celebrate 50, 60, and 25 years of faithful service, that the divine heart of Jesus may bless their dedication and increase their fruitfulness through ever deeper union with him. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the Carmelite sisters of the divine heart of Jesus, that God in his goodness may give them a deep love of prayer, a spirit of penance, and zeal in the apostolate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For vocations to the priesthood and consecrated life, that holy families may foster in our young people the call to share in the work of the harvest, and through them many souls may find their home in the divine heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all of us here present, that as we hear the words of our divine master calling us to be perfect, we may bear fruit in holiness, and when we reach the measure of the fullness of Christ, we may all meet in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
God our Father, in your goodness you called these servants of yours to follow Christ in his perfection. To the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary, pour out your Holy Spirit upon them, that they may continue with unfailing dedication in the promise they once made. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice and
prayers for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all the Church.
Receiving compassion, Holy Father, the offerings we bring you, and grant fraternal communion and spiritual freedom to all who set over joyfully to imitate your Son by following the narrow way. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and just. It is truly right and just. Or during our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him, we have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all and sharing His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross, brought peace to all creation. Therefore, He has been exalted above all things, and to all who obey Him has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." faith.
Anunciamos tu muerte y tu resurrección hasta que vuelvas, Señor Jesús. Anunciamos tu muerte y tu resurrección hasta que vuelvas, Señor Jesús.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Gustavo, our Archbishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Transformed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. And our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Gracious, we grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of Jesus,
and our Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance to your will, for this reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Thank you.
con ellos. Strengthen your servants, O Lord, with this spiritual food and drink, so that always faithful to the call of the gospel, they may make present everywhere the living image of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Dear family, on behalf of the sisters, we thank you for being with them. And on a personal note, Sister Barbara, sisters, thank you for letting me be with you this last week. I'm prepared for this wonderful occasion to celebrate with you. And grateful to Bishop Gustavo. We thank you, Bishop, on behalf of the sisters, really. And myself, too, don't get me wrong. But it's always a great joy to see you, Your Excellency, and the priests who are here, who serve the sisters faithfully, day in and day out. And the joy that you bring to us as priests, as well as they, I hope and pray we bring you joy too, by the way. But there's a reception prepared for us to partake in, celebrating our jubilarians, and they invite you to please join them for that as well. And please follow the procession to Our Lady of Mount Carmel for the singing of the Magnificat, followed by a luncheon in the dining room. So that's word for word right there. So thank you.
To all of you, sisters of this Carmel Sacred Heart, thank you for all your prayers, because you hold in your hearts so many intentions from so many people, and also all your actions of power, those prayers. We appreciate them. We need you. That is why we are going to get some vocations for you in God's grace. Do we commit ourselves to help the sisters with vocations?
Yes.
You got the message. All right, sisters. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.